Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff Hirsch. I'm here at the Traders Expo in Las Vegas, November 2019, with my buddy Ryan Shannon, AlphaTrends.net president and founder. You're a VWAP man. What? Let's talk about how the VWAP works, what makes it up, what are the components, how to use it.
Okay,
fantastic. What's it stand for, first of all?
Volume-weighted average price. So it's three components: price, volume, time.
Okay.
Basic components in the market. Real super easy to understand. No complicated formulas or anything like that. The volume weighted average price started out in 1988 as a benchmark for institutions to say, how well is my order being executed versus how the stock traded throughout the day. It's like a dollar cost average.
How the market makers were working for them.
Yeah, exactly. Are they doing a good job or are they doing a bad job? Because they didn't have an actual benchmark. So this is the dollar cost average. If someone puts $1,000 a month into a stock, they know that they bought 15 shares 1 month, 12 shares 1 month, 18 shares as the price goes up. So it's the average, the volume weighted average price, just like it sounds.
So you're looking at a stock, call it pick a stock, trading in some day.
Alibaba right now.
Alibaba, trading in, you're looking at over a couple of hours, a few minutes, an afternoon.
Great question. So it's applicable on any time frame. The way that you look at it, traditionally, it's been that end of day benchmark.
Right.
But you can it calculates from any point forward. So for the intraday, it would be from 9:30, 10,000 shares trades from 9:30 to 9:31. What's the average price of that? It's cumulative throughout the day, so it represents as a moving average on the
so
price.
So you could pick a half hour period and get your VWAP. You could pick the whole day and get your VWAP.
That's where anchoring comes in, where you could say, okay, since the Federal Reserve announced at 2:15 Eastern, I want to put an anchor on that and say, what's the average price since that event? It's the psychology. So like any moving average, it often acts as support or resistance, and it gives you just a feel of the trend for that specific time frame.
So the more shares that are traded at a particular price makes that price
more important.
More weighted in the average. Almost
correct.
Like an exponential moving average where the weight's on the most recent price point.
Perfectly explained. It's not an arbitrary time thing, and it's not a weighted time thing. When I say arbitrary, 50 days is arbitrary in my mind, right? Why do we use 50 days? It should be 63.
This is half of 100.
There's 252 days in a trading year, so let's talk about quarters. That's the way we report earnings and that sort of thing, right?
The weekly things because we live in weeks, The old put-call ratio that used to have in Barron's, the weekly put-call ratio was significant because it was one whole business week.
Right. Yeah.
Or trading week.
Exactly. And so it should be a quarter. Anyways, that's a different subject.
That's a whole
other. Back to the VWAP. Yeah. It does act like it, so it represents as a moving average from whatever you choose as the anchor. I'll use anchors from a Federal Reserve on a very short-term time frame.
An important event.
Yep. It could be earnings report, and that earnings report will be significant, 3 to 9 months down the road. You'd be surprised. Year-to-date is a great one because that's how big institutions get paid. They, how do I compare versus the S&P 500 or whatever their benchmark is. Let's say they're a transportation portfolio manager. How did I compare to the Dow Transport Index?
So just give us, you mentioned Alibaba a second ago. Give us a quick example of the volume weighted average price of Alibaba on a particular time frame that you've looked at recently.
So I'll use multiple time frames, going back to my book, Technical Analysis, using multiple time frames. You always want to start with the bigger picture just to have a feel of what is that general trend? Where's the big money,
I do that with the seasonal stuff. Multiple time frames, very important.
And seasonal, too. And seasonal is part of Alibaba as well. November 11th is coming up. That's the, they call it Singles Day in China, where it's the number one retailing event on the planet.
Like Black Friday here.
Correct, yeah. So Alibaba often runs up. I look back, and it often runs up in front of the November 11th,
So you're looking
next
for the
Monday.
VWAP in front of the November 11th.
Well, so what I'll do is I'll look at a chart, and let's say it ran up, pulled back. I'll look at, from that most recent run-up, what's the average price? And it'll often act as support. And then from the high of that move, let's say this is a move that took place over 2 weeks, I'll put a volume-weighted average price off the top. And as those VWAPs kind of pinch together, it shows that we're reaching that equilibrium.
And that's your buy point.
And as it breaks above that level, then I want to get involved. And I'll start to manage my risk against the definition of trends. higher lows and higher highs. So whatever the most recent relevant higher low is for that time frame I'm involved in,
and that's
where I'll set my stop initially.
That's where your expertise comes in play at alphatrends.net.
That's what I do.
Knowing where to start that VWAP calculation from.
Exactly, and teaching people the art of, and that's the art part of it. Where do you anchor from? And it's really actually not that difficult, Jeff. It's, you know, depending on your time frame, you know, a day trader is going to look at the VWAP for the day. Week to date is often important for near term moves. Monthly, quarterly, year to date is a good one. From earnings, it's really a versatile tool, and you'd be surprised how often it's like the exact low or the exact high. It's crazy.
Fantastic.
It blows my mind every day.
Thank you very much, Brian. Thanks everybody for joining us. VWAP.
VWAP.